Now let's talk about the application of SFE on a throttling device. So this is a throttling operation going on. So you have a pipeline in which a fluid is flowing. You have water, you can have water, you can have steam flowing through this pipeline. And you see on the board is an adjusting valve. So you can adjust this valve to throttle the flow of the fluid on the both sides. All right. So let us say on this side you have velocity V1 and on this side you have velocity V2. Okay. Now let us say this pipe is insulated. Let us say we are carrying steam in this pipeline. So because it's steam, we need to conserve that energy. We can't afford it to be lost into the atmosphere. You need to put some insulation. So the Q dot value becomes zero. Okay. Now, because it's just a flow of steam in a pipeline, there is no perceivable useful work output, neither input. So W dot also becomes zero. Okay. Now one more thing. If you take this as your reference plane, okay, the fluid elevation at both entrance and exit, they are same. So you also have to assume that delta PE is zero. Okay, so what is left if you take per unit mass basis? You are only left with delta H plus delta KE is equal to zero. Okay, so throttling is basically allowing a fluid to pass through some constricted region, some resistance. So if you little bit open this valve, let us say when you open this valve, the new position of the valve, let us say is this. So this is the position of the valve. So now what will happen? Fluid will start flowing beneath it. So you will have the fluid which will be flowing through this passage. So you, this is still a restriction to it, because the majority of the fluid is being resisted by this much circumference of the valve. So this is a throttling of the fluid flow. Okay, so you are controlling the amount of fluid that would pass on to the other side. Okay, so this is the equation that is left for your analysis. Now this would give you H2 minus H1 plus V2 square minus V1 square upon 2 is equal to 0. You can take them on either side, so you will have H2 plus V2 square by 2 is equal to H1 plus V1 square by 2. Okay, so this is the equation that is left for you to understand. Okay, now in some cases the velocity at inlet and the velocity at outlet are very very comparable. So you can say that these two would cancel. These two would cancel if V1 becomes equal to V2. There is no velocity increase. It is almost the same. Then you are just left with H1 is equal to H2. This means that for a perfect fluid or for a perfect gas, the enthalpy at entrance and outlet is same in the case of throttling. Okay. Now if you apply the definition of enthalpy, this is what you get, isn't it? So Cp and Cp would cancel out. So T1 is equal to T2. So this gives you a very important observation to note down, that in case of a throttling process for a perfect gas, the temperatures at inlet and outlet are same, because there is no enthalpy drop across the throttling device. Okay, so I hope you understood this very important and easy application of SFEE on a throttling device. Now we have covered all the applications of SFEE on the various devices. Now let's move on to the numerical portion of the application of SFEE on these devices that we have studied in this video series. Now from the next video onwards, let's start solving numericals on this.